Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths tutorial. Again, very important theorem from Riemann integration. Let us see this. F maps closed interval a comma b into capital R is a continuous function on closed interval a comma b. Then f is Riemann integrable on closed interval a comma b. It means a continuous function on closed interval a comma b is Riemann integrable on closed interval a comma b. That's all. Let us see the proof. Let f max closed interval a comma b into capital R is a continuous function on closed interval a comma b. F is continuous on closed interval a comma b. We know that every continuous function is bounded. Therefore, f is bounded on closed interval a comma b. Since f is continuous on closed interval a comma b, every continuous function satisfies Borel's theorem. So, what is Borel's theorem statement? For each epsilon greater than 0, there exists a partition P satisfying this condition, mod f of yr minus f of zr less than epsilon by b minus a for yr comma zr belongs to ir, where r is equals to 1 to and so on small n. Remember that here in this theorem, Borel's theorem is the very important part. You must learn this. Since f is continuous on closed interval a comma b, then f satisfies the Borel's property. This is also known as Borel's property. F satisfies the Borel's property. What is that? For each epsilon greater than 0, there exists a partition P such that mod f of yr minus f of zr less than epsilon by b minus a for yr comma zr belongs to ir, where r varies from 1 to n. Now, define infimum and supremum. Small mr, capital MR be the infimum and supremum of F in IR. What is IR? Rth subinterval. Here, the term IR means Rth subinterval, which is a closed interval XR minus 1 comma XR, and it is subset to closed interval A comma B, corresponding to the partition P. Small MR means infimum. Capital MR means supremum of the function F defined in IR. Since F is continuous on IR, it means you observe that f is continuous on closed interval a comma b. F is continuous on closed interval a comma b means f is continuous in each and every subinterval of closed interval a comma b. So f is continuous in IR also. Therefore, by applying Borel's property, there exists alpha r comma beta r belongs to IR such that f of alpha r is equals to mr, I mean infimum. F of beta r is equals to capital mr, supremum. So, now apply the Borel's theorem. Now apply the Borel's theorem to our function f in the interval IR. Now apply the Borel's property to our function f over the rth subinterval IR. Capital MR minus small MR is equals to mod f of beta R minus f of alpha. Capital MR f of beta R minus f of alpha R, small MR f of alpha R. So, which is less than, by applying Borel's property, epsilon by b minus a. What it means? Capital MR minus small MR is less than epsilon by b minus a. Remember that. Now take delta R is the length of the rth subinterval. Delta R is the length of the rth subinterval. Let delta R be the length of rth subinterval IR. Now, UPF minus LPF, upper Riemann sum minus lower Riemann sum. What is upper Riemann sum? Summation R is equals to 1 to N, capital MR, delta R, minus lower Riemann sum. What is lower Riemann sum? Summation R is equals to 1 to N, small MR, delta R, which is equals to summation R is equals to 1 to N, capital MR minus small MR into delta R. You observe that capital MR minus small MR is less than epsilon by B minus K. So this equality becomes less than summation R is equals to 1 to N, epsilon by B minus A into delta R. Epsilon by b minus a is independent of r, which is less than summation r is equals to 1 to n, which is less than epsilon by b minus a into summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r. we know that summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r is equals to b minus a. Already we learned this. Summation r is equals to 1 to n delta r is nothing but b minus a, which is less than epsilon by b minus a into b minus a. These two terms get cancelled, which is less than epsilon. Therefore, UPF minus LPF is less than epsilon for the partition P belongs to pi of a comma b. This is nothing but the necessary and sufficient condition for a function to be Riemann integrable. UPF minus LPF less than epsilon is the necessary and sufficient condition for a non-empty set, for a function f to be Riemann integrable. Therefore, f is Riemann integrable. F is Riemann integrable on closed interval a comma b. This completes the proof. Hence proved. Observe that, again, very very important theorem for section a as well as for section b. Observe that.